down a beat. Good. All right, now let's all say Acts 2:8-19 together. Here we go.
Acts 2:8-19. Acts 2:8-19. Acts 2:8-19.
Perfect. I'm going to sing on top of you. Get ready.
Acts 2:8-19.
How do we know how to be saved?
Acts 2:8-19.
Why do we baptize in Jesus' name?
Acts 2:8-19.
How do we know we must speak in tongues?
Acts 2:8-19.
Tell me, how do we get to heaven?
Acts 2:8-19.
Again.
Acts 2:8-19.
One more time.
Acts 2:8-19.
What's going on, kids? First Church Blue Bomber kids out there.
First Church Blue Bomber!
Congratulations to all you graduates out there.
Fifth grade, graduates!
We all did it one time.
Yep.
Some more than others.
That was a long time ago.
I know it's getting hot. Summertime's here.
Hot.
But we're here to have some fun.
That's right.
Hey, also, you know what I just thought of?
What's that?
Birthdays!
Yeah!
May and June birthdays! It's already June. I can't believe it's already June.
Crazy, yeah.
Speaking of May and June birthdays, Melody, if you're watching, I know it's your birthday today, girl.
Happy birthday!
And you know what, Tracy? You had a birthday on Thursday. Happy birthday, man!
Happy birthday, Tracy!
Hey, and Tristan Fernandez, I know you got one at the end of the month, bro.
Coming up.
Happy birthday.
And a quick one, Asher. Happy birthday coming up next week.
Happy birthday.
Hey. Should we, maybe sing happy birthday real quick?
Good idea.
Okay, let's do it.
On three. One, two, three.
This is your birthday song. It isn't very long.
Hey!
Hey, so hope you guys have been watching. And this is Saturday, actually, instead of Sunday. So we're having Sunday school on Saturday. All right, so something to make sure you guys know about, coming up in 2 weeks, we're gonna go ahead and have Zoom Sunday school on Saturday. All right, Saturday, 10 a.m. Let's make sure that all of you come to the same place, fcsanjose.org, and make sure when you click that link, we're gonna have the opportunity for you to be able to hop in with your teachers and all your other classmates, and we're gonna have Zoom Sunday school on Saturday, coming up in 2 weeks. So, how many of you guys remember what we learned about last week? You guys remember that? It was
Esther.
Esther, that's queen. Right.
The queen.
The queen, right? And we learned about how, just like Esther, God has prepared us for such a time as this, right?
This time, right.
That even during all the things that are happening right now, that God has made it so that we can be able to do something for Him during this time, huh? That no matter what, we can pray, that no matter what, we can stand for Him, and that we can be able to make a difference, right?
That's right.
You know what? This week, we're going to learn about Daniel.
Daniel.
So, Daniel in the lion's den is our story today. And the big thing that we want you to be able to see throughout this whole story today is that even when it isn't easy, we need to stand up for God. Because it's not about doing what's easy, it's about doing what's right.
What's right.
So let's go ahead and check out this next part of the story here.
You know what else is awesome? Is that God's word is always relevant.
That's right.
It doesn't matter.
Amen.
It's 2020
right.
And God's word is always true.
Still
that's everything
true.
We're going through right now.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's check it out.
Now we go to the time of King Darius and Daniel. At this time, there were 120 princes that King Darius had who reigned over the whole kingdom with him. Over these princes were three presidents. And of these three presidents, Daniel was the king's favorite. All the princes had to obey the three presidents, and of the three presidents, Daniel was the king's closest advisor. They were the best of friends, or BFFs, if you will. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
All right, hey, boys and girls, we're gonna do some worship. We got this really cool song. It's talking about walking like lions, walking brave, walking bold. We even got some stuff, references like flying like eagles. So definitely get those arms ready, get those feet ready, get those legs ready. We're gonna worship. But remember, we're worshiping God because it's the right thing to do. Sometimes there's tough times. Sometimes there's things that are not easy, but you just do them because it's the right thing to do. So that's what we're gonna sing and we're gonna worship about right now. So get those wings ready. Let's walk. We're gonna walk like lions too.
Today we live, today we breathe, today we know that we are strong when we are weak. Today we trust, we overcome. Take every chain that kept us slaves and throw them off. We're not waiting for permission. We defy our inhibition. Like our middle name is Fearless Son of Red. If we're gonna fly,
Daniel, why is he the king's favorite? I'm one of the presidents too. I don't get to eat crepes with the king. I don't get to play paper, rock, scissors. I'm pretty good at paper, rock, scissors. Oh, I don't understand. I bought the king a really cool set of Persian golf clubs. Did the king care? No! The king just wanted to play more paper, rock, scissors with Daniel! Daniel's so cool! Oh, let's hang out with Daniel! Let's hear about Daniel's God! Oh! I'm so sick of it! I'm so sick of every time I hear Daniel say, oh, thank God! Thank God! There's something we can do here. I know there's some way we can get him! Oh, we're gonna get Daniel. What can I do, though? No matter what we think about, I can't find anything wrong with Daniel. Oh, he's so perfect, it drives me crazy. Oh,
Man, his feet don't smell. He never does anything wrong. He used to always get straight A's. What can we do? Oh, think. Oh, all he does all day is do things perfect and pray to his God, and that's it. That's what we're gonna do. All he does is pray to his God. That's how we're gonna get him. I'm sure the king feels like that he should be the most important person. We need to go ahead and make a law that makes it so he is the most important person in the kingdom, even more important than somebody's God, like Daniel's God. Yeah. Okay, that's what we're gonna do. Oh, King, live forever.
Yes.
King, I was thinking the other day, you know, you're the most important person in this entire kingdom.
Got a good point there.
Oh yes, I think so too. You know, I think you are the biggest deal in this kingdom. Bigger, more important than any prince, any other king, even any god.
Guess I'm a pretty big deal.
Yes, you are. You're the biggest deal, King.
I like the sound of that.
Yeah, you know, we shouldn't just make that an assumption. We should make that a law, don't you think?
Sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
What do you got? What do you think?
It should. Everyone should know that you're the most important one. King, I think we should have a law that says that if anyone has a request, that they shouldn't be praying or asking or pleading anything to any other power other than you for the next 30 days. Because King, you're the biggest deal. You're a big deal, King. Don't you think?
I like how you think.
Yeah, I like how I think too. I mean, yes! Yes, that's perfect. That's perfect, King. That's a great idea you just had.
Yeah,
let's go ahead and do that. What do you think?
Whatever you got planned, let's make it happen.
Yes, let's make it happen. Let's change the law so no one can pray to their God.
What's up, kids? Man, did you see that? He was trying to put a person above Jesus. We all know there's only one true God, right? How many gods are there? One, and his name is Jesus. For the Bible says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord." So get up and get ready. And let's start to sing about Jesus, the one true God.
You are the one true God. There will never be another. You are the faithful God. Forever we will praise your name. You are the one true God. There will never be another. You are.
So the law was changed so that no one could be praying to anyone else but the king for the next 30 days. But even though circumstances had changed around Daniel, the circumstances didn't change Daniel. Daniel was still a man of prayer. And every day, three times a day, Daniel still faithfully prayed to his God. Let's go ahead and look in on that right now.
Oh Lord, my God. I know right now they have made a decree that I'm not supposed to pray to you.
I knew it.
But that doesn't matter.
So predictable.
For your laws and your ways are above our ways. And you are King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and I will follow you all the days of my life. And I pray, Lord, that even though I'm not supposed to be doing this, that I be not punished. But even if I am, I know your hand is in the situation, and I will come through unscathed. And I thank you, Lord, for the relationship that you have blessed me with the king. I thank you for the favor that you have given me. And even though there are some that may not like me, I pray for them. I pray for the princes and the presidents and the other rulers of the nation, that you would keep your hand upon them and that you would turn their heart to you, O God. I love you and I praise you.
O King, live forever.
Yes.
Remember that law that you had signed into place?
Yes.
The law over the Medes and Persians about how for the next 30 days, people can only pray or ask petitions of you?
Yes, I remember that. That was a good idea you had.
Yeah, And
how's that going?
Pretty good. I'm trying to remember. I just want to make sure. And we were saying that if anybody broke the law, that they get thrown into a den of lions, like a big cave of lions, right?
Yes, that is what we agreed on.
That's what we agreed on. Okay, so you do remember that, right?
Yes.
Okay, good. Because somebody's broken the law.
Really?
Yes, and that someone is Daniel! So, King, Daniel's broken the law. I can go ahead and get the lion's pits ready, though.
There's gotta be a way around this.
Oh, King, it's a law. You agreed to this, and not even you can go against your own law.
It's true.
Okay, so
sorry,
I'm
sorry, Daniel.
I'm gonna go ahead and get that lion's pit ready. Come on, Daniel, let's go.
This is so frustrating right now. I did not fully think about that law when it was presented to me. Oh, it's all my fault. I should have thought that through. Daniel's one of my best men. I cannot believe I didn't think. He's always praying to his God. I should have known better than to pass a law like that. Oh, there's got to be something I could do to get him out of this. Well, he is always praying to his God. I really hope his God bails him out of this. It's all I can lean on right now. Man, it's frustrating. I can't even eat. Can't even sleep. This is gonna bug me all night.
Talkies. Anybody hungry? Thanks, God. Very good. Oh well. Sorry, Chester. More for me. Man, did you guys see that? Woo! Dude, that was crazy. You see all those lions? That was like a little scary. Well, kind of not scary, because you know, when you pray and you ask God, he's got your back, no matter what. You know what? He'll even shut the mouth of lions for you. Because God is all powerful. No matter what could be happening in your lives, Prayer changes things. Always remember that, kids. Even when the lions roar, God will stop the mouths of lions.
Daniel, are you all right in there? Daniel, did your God save you? Daniel, I'm trying to look out for you. Are you all right? Daniel!
Hey, King, I'm doing fine down here. God saved me. He sent his angels and he shut the mouth of lions. Man, it was so awesome. I wasn't even scared at all. Man, God is so good. He'll protect you through anything. Also, did you know lions like Funyuns? Man, it was so cool down here. I wish I had some more chips, though. They ate them all. Oh, yeah. I even got to ride the lions. It was like being at a carnival. Yeah, I wasn't even scared. Well, maybe just a little bit. But man, I tried to give these lions my Takis and my Cheetos, but they wouldn't take them. I mean, there's a lion or a cat on the bag. And you'd think they'd want some. But, I mean, I guess their mouths were shut. Oh well, more for me.
You've got a friend in me.
And the king was so glad and excited. And he commanded that they should take Daniel out of the den. So, they went and took Daniel out of the den. And when they pulled him out, they saw that there weren't any hurts on him because he believed in his God. And then the king commanded that they bring the men that accused Daniel and that they be cast in with the lions.
Bye!
Unfortunately for them, they didn't believe in Daniel's God, so they didn't have Daniel's God protecting them. Very unfortunately for them.
Hey kids, it's time for another song. Let's get up. Let's get more active. So, we are going to share that God is good in every way. Just like Daniel, he's trusting in his God because God is good in every way. Even when things seem tight, even when things seem like it's just pressure and things are just not going right and there's nothing you can do about it. God is good in every way. Always remember that. God is good in every way.
Come on now, join with me, everybody sing. I'm gonna lift my voice to glorify my King. He is a mighty God and worthy of our praise. We give him everything, he's good in every way. Come on now, join with me, everybody sing. I'm gonna lift my voice to glorify my King. He is a mighty God and worthy of our praise. We give him everything, he's good in every way.
He is always there for us.
He's good in every way.
Pouring out his awesome love.
He's good in every way.
He fills us up with peace and joy.
He's good in every way.
He gives us all we need and more.
He's good in every way.
Come on now, join,
come
yeah.
Come on now, join with me, everybody sing. I'm gonna lift my voice to glorify my King. He is a mighty God. He is a mighty God and worthy of our praise. We give him everything, he's good in every way. He's good in every way. He's good in every way.
So Daniel, I am so happy God had your back, man.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
Like, I don't fully understand it, but you pray. I know you pray. You are a praying man.
Prayer works, kids.
God had your back that whole time. Like, I couldn't even imagine, like, lions. Like, what did you say? It closed their mouth?
He closed their mouths.
Wow. That's powerful.
That's a big old mouth.
That's powerful. So I totally understand now why you say one true God.
There's only one true God. And when you pray, he hears you. And even though it's not always easy, and you're in the middle of a storm, you're in that boat, and that storm and that waves are coming at you, guess who's in that boat with you? Jesus. And he's going to see you through that storm. Just remember, always pray, because prayer changes things.
Yes, and Daniel, I got to share with you that when I didn't know what to do, and I did not want that law to happen, I was telling myself, I know Daniel prays. And I even said it. I said, I hope God bails him out. But now, I know for sure what you're saying. I've seen it with my own eyes. God will do it.
Yes, he will.
And so I thank you for that influence. Because your praying brought an understanding to me.
It's one thing that you can learn from this lesson, kids.
remember to pray, because God hears you and He wants to hear you. He wants to get to know you, and He wants you to get to know Him. Let's all end this in prayer. Jesus, we love you today. We thank you for this wonderful opportunity, God, to be here. We come before you humbly. We love you. God, even in the middle of these crazy times right now, Jesus, we know that you are in control. You have the final say. You are the King of Kings, God. We trust you. We love you. God, we know, Lord, that you have the best interest for
the biggest situation.
You know our today, and you know our tomorrow.
We put our trust in you. We lean upon you.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are the one true God.
The one true God.
And you are mighty and worthy of our praise.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.